Hello, I'm Graham and welcome to the final part in this mini-series where I've been looking at taking better pictures with the Panasonic Lumix FZ200 camera. In today's video I'd like to show you how, by mastering just a few basic rules of composition, you will turn ordinary snapshots into images you will be proud of. All elements in nature, such as shapes, lines, textures, patterns, scale and form, when isolated and highlighted, can become the subject of an exceptional photograph. However, it's more likely that we as photographers may wish to combine a number of these elements to create our perfect image. Unlike painters, until the arrival of digital imaging, we weren't able to remove detail which distracts from an ideal picture. We have to learn a few camera techniques to minimise these natural problems, that is, unless we want to resort to some form of digital manipulation in the final image. To do this, you may wish to move closer to the subject or further away. Tilt the camera up or downwards, or you use the camera vertically or horizontally. Or you could creatively use ISO, shutter, aperture or lens focal length. How you use these options depends on the visual connection you want to make with the viewer in the final image. There aren't any hard and fast rules about composition, however there are some general guidelines I can give you to help create better images. Your ultimate goal as a photographer is to create an image that will effectively convey your subject, theme or idea to the viewer. Composition is a deliberate effort and forces good camera discipline. You have to choose the elements of the scene and then arrange them to create the effect that you want. Sometimes just one element is sufficient to execute your idea, and other times it is more complex. Simplification is the easiest way to convey a powerful image. Often your main subject will be the dominant feature and it's supported by other elements to balance the composition. A dominant subject doesn't have to be one of physical size, it can be one with a stronger colour tone. Logically we'd assume that the most harmonious compositions come from symmetry. We see the main point of focus being central and all other elements equally separated on either side. However, it's been shown that our curiosity prefers at least two elements to create tension and a sense of movement. The sense of balance comes from primary colours balanced by more muted hues, or intricate detail shape balanced by spacious areas, or dark masses surrounded by lighter tones. One trusted formula for creating a natural balance and point of interest for the viewer is to use the rule of thirds. This rule was devised by Greeks and has been used by painters ever since. As you look through the viewfinder or at the LCD screen on the camera, you mentally divide the scene vertically and horizontally into thirds. The FZ200 has a convenient grid overlay which you can turn on to do this for you. It also helps you get the verticals vertical and horizons level. Subjects which are placed on or near an intersection of the grid become an immediate off-center emphasis in your image. In simpler situations, the lines divide the subject into simple one-third, two-third compositions. You can also alter the viewpoint of your image as well as its mood and impact simply by changing your camera angle. Shooting from a lower than eye level emphasizes your subject and they appear more powerful and dominant. Shooting from above makes your subjects more diminished. So if you're shooting, say for example, a person and you want to make them appear more powerful, shoot from a slightly below eye level viewpoint. Landscapes can have the mood dramatically altered by camera position. When a scene is shot from a low angle, it emphasizes the sky and cloud structure. When it's shot from a higher position, the horizon will move up and this emphasizes the spaciousness of the landscape. Both of these techniques can be employed to simplify composition. Shooting from a low angle allows us to isolate subjects against the sky, and shooting from a higher viewpoint may help us remove a cluttered background. The simplest way of applying composition to your images is sometimes in the selection of either a vertical, often referred to as a portrait format, or horizontal landscape format. A lot will depend on your subject choice, but also it depends on your output medium. A vertical shot doesn't ideally fit in a horizontal 16:9 HD format, for example. If you're in doubt, shoot both. You may find the one that works best is not the one you anticipated at the point of shooting. One of the most common failings in beginner's images is the failure to fill the visual frame with the subject image. Decide on the most important feature and then fill the frame, either by moving in, to the subject or by using the telephoto setting that you have on the FZ200. Everything we look at is, to some extent or another, influenced by perspective. Objects which are close to us appear larger than those of the same size, but further away. We as photographers can easily change the influence of perspective by choosing different focal lengths. A telephoto setting will compress distance and allow us to distort the impact of distant objects. Similarly, a wide-angle lens exaggerates foreground objects and diminishes background objects. Many landscape shots are let down by the lack of a dominant focal point. A tree, a solitary building, the sun, or even an animal can give this important aspect to your image. The classical way to achieve this is to find this focal point in urban situations by the addition of a human figure or statue, for example. We humans are always fascinated by a scene which has a human subject. A second method is to pre-compose your shot and then wait for the focal point to move into it, such as this human element, or a boat in a seascape, or maybe a fallen petal in a flower study. The way our eyes wander across an image can be controlled by the clever use of leading lines. These can be naturally occurring, or more usually, man-made. Avenues of trees, forest tracks, fences, waves, for example, are all commonly used leading lines. These are often referred to as linear perspectives, and can be seen even in images of buildings shot with the camera tilted up to visually distort this viewpoint, especially if we use a wide-angle lens. These lines direct our viewer's eye into or across our image. If these can be combined with a dominant subject situated on one of our rules of thirds intersections, then we have an image with a lot more appeal. If we use curves to create this leading effect, they seem graceful and yielding, whilst diagonal lines are more powerful and aggressive, so try to ensure your lines are sympathetic to your principal point of interest. Sometimes it helps to provide a frame which keeps the viewer's interest centred in your image. It can be a natural frame, such as an overhanging branch in a landscape, to a bridge or other structure to contain your viewer's attention. Frames within frames also add drama to your image and can convey a powerful message to your viewer. As with leading lines, having something interesting in the foreground acts as a stepping stone to lead the viewer into the picture. It also helps to balance a composition if there's a very strong visual element in the background. Foreground objects also add scale and distance to your image, inviting the viewer to compare and contrast the foreground objects with those in the background. Be careful though that any secondary points of interest don't compete for visual attention, especially those at the edges of the frames, as they can become the opposite and form a distraction. In all images, we have to be very careful about the type of composition we apply in creating our picture. If we succeed in getting all these elements right, then we've done what we set out to achieve, and we have evoked some form of emotion in our viewer. Remember, these are just guidelines and not mandatory for each image. Some very powerful images break all these rules but still convey powerful emotions, but for most parts, following my simple suggestions will improve your photography. Well, I hope you found this video and the two preceding ones helpful in helping you create better images. I am passionate about my photography and I'm still learning how to achieve beautiful images, even some 50 years after buying my first camera and setting up my first black and white darkroom. It's you, the photographer, that creates the emotion with your image. The camera is merely a tool to accomplish this, and with the Panasonic Lumix FZ200, you have a complete set of controls to be able to be expressive and creative with your image making. Thanks for watching. Hope to see you in my next videos. Bye for now.